State troopers stepped up this weekend in an effort to help make Minneapolis safer and to try to curb scenes like this. Remember that from the Mill District last weekend? But just how effective were these extra patrols? We wanted to know. So our Charmaine Nero is breaking down the numbers.
Days after video shows people firing off fireworks into condos and balconies in Minneapolis's Mill District, law enforcement agencies increased patrols, releasing those numbers today. Chaos seen in these videos from the July 4th holiday in the Mill District.
This is conduct that should not be acceptable in any city.
Forcing city leaders and law enforcement agencies to step up safety efforts, putting down barriers and increase patrols. This weekend, Minnesota State Patrol assigned 20 additional troopers and air patrol resources to designated areas of the Twin Cities with a focus on street racing. Altogether, making 250 traffic stops in Minneapolis Saturday, with 52 drivers cited for driving without a valid license and 20 arrests, 11 of those for driving while impaired. Other citations were given out to drivers racing on the freeway and Hennepin Avenue. Friday, Commissioner John Harrington with the Minnesota Department of Public Safety said the department, along with State Patrol, would step up efforts to combat recent crime, citing a rise in gun-related crimes, carjackings, and street racing in Minneapolis seen over the course of 2 years.
Initiated a conversation with the city of Minneapolis to talk about what could the state do to assist.
The Minnesota State Patrol issued a statement saying, "Our goal was to swell resources to combat street racing and other illegal activity over the weekend. The results generated speak for themselves." A spokesperson with Minneapolis Police tells us those barriers will remain up indefinitely in the Mill District area. Reporting in Minneapolis, Charmaine Nero, KARE 11 News.